with the child in four point position, horse position, or standing on four legs. We ask the child to lift one hand, hold it for the count of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. Then we ask the child to lift one leg. Straight, stabilizing hand, one at the hip waist level, other hand under the knee. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. Once the child has mastered holding hand and leg independently for the count of five, then we ask the child to lift one hand and opposite side leg. So in case we lift right hand, we take the left leg and vice versa. Hold it for the count of five. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. While holding this position, we need to make sure the child doesn't look in front. I repeat, the child doesn't look in front. The child has to look down. Number two, palms, that is the hands, will be right under the shoulder level. They will not be in front. They will not be at the back. They have to be under the shoulder level. Knees have to be under the hip. Neither ahead nor back. Make sure while holding the position, the hand and the leg are held in a straight position. Next exercise, the child is lying flat on the back, hands at the side. Usually we prefer keeping the hands on the head, but considering the weak core muscles, it is a difficult task. So we begin with the child keeping the hands at the side, so some amount of support is ensured from the hands. But it's only at the beginning of the exercises. When we progress to higher level, we can keep the hands at the head level. So we start with, you put your one hand under the ankle, keep your knees apart. Lift the child's legs up. Hold it for 5 counts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. With the other hand, you stabilize the knees so that the child is not bending the knees. The hand will stabilize the knees. Hold this position and put it down. We usually tend to do when we have to lift the legs up. We tend to ask the child to lift it up. This will not activate the core muscles. We have to lift it only up to 45 degrees max. So beginning with only 10 degrees at the beginning, then we can progress to 45 degrees. If not 5 counts, 3 counts is absolutely fine. But hold it. Then put it down. We will not lift the legs beyond 45 degrees. When we progress, the hands will be on the head. Then we ask the child, lift the legs. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. Exercise for today for core strengthening. We keep the hands next to the shoulders. I repeat, the palm of the child will be next to the shoulders. It cannot be in front, it cannot be at the back, at the shoulder level. This is the first marker of this exercise. Second, we keep the feet closer to each other. The feet will not be wide open. They will not cross each other. They will be next to each other, close by. We initiate the movement by keeping one hand on the chest, other hand on the back as the stabilizing hand. And ask the child to lift. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There is no hurry to ask the child to keep the arms straight. The first point is to only make the child come up on his hands. Once the child masters it, we can progress by straightening the elbows. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. At all times, the child will look directly in front. Not up, nor down. The eye gaze will be right in the front. In this position, you can ask the child to give high five. Or you can ask him to do some activities like fixing the puzzle board or throwing the ball inside the basket. A fourth exercise for bow strengthening begins with a child lying flat on the back. I repeat, on the back, not on the tummy. We start with bending the knees, feet on the floor. You put your hand under the knees, ask the child, lift your feet. Once he has lifted the feet, your hand support will be on the ankle or on the feet. Clench the feet as the child is just beginning with this exercise to give good support. Hold this position. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this posture, the child can sing, recite a poem, count numbers, say alphabet, anything, talk or speak so that he doesn't hold his breath. Once we hold this position for the count of 5, we put the feet down. As in when you progress, the hand support on the ankle will be looser and looser, and more of the weight will be taken by the child's core muscles itself. We progress further by lifting the feet up, hip at 90, knees at 90. Ask the child, touch your knees. Hold this position for the count of 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. As you maintain this position, make sure the child is not lifting the head up, not curving the back much. The back will be on the floor flat. To ensure that you will have one hand supporting the tummy so that you hold a control over the back being lifted from the floor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And as it goes in this position, you too have to ask the child to speak, sing, count, say alphabet, anything but talk, anything and talk. Again, the child is on the tummy. We keep both the hands in front, legs straight at the back. Your position, that is therapist position, will be next to the child. You keep one hand under the hands, the other hand on the middle of the back. Ask the child to lift the hands, both hands together. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. We practice this position. Once the child is mastered with the hands, we allow the child to lift the hands on his own. Our next job is to assist with the legs. Our hand position will be under the knees, maintaining it straight. Other hand on the back to stabilize. Now I tell the child, lift your hands up, and I slowly lift the legs, maybe slightly above the ground level. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Down. I will not force the child to lift it like this, because as you see, we have an older kid that we are dealing with. I lift both the legs stressfully. I put a weight on my back. So I just keep my hand under the knee and wait for the child to initiate the movement on his own. I just assist him by slightly lifting the knees up. At all times, your back will be straight. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now in this exercise, we tend to keep our hands down and pull it up this way, which is a wrong way. Our main motto is to keep the hands and the knees straight and put a stress on the core muscles. So the contraction happens at the core muscles. Thank you.